Right, I'm ready to start working in my journal. Very excited. So I've got my mini misters with just paint and water in them, and hopefully they are not clogged. And I'm just literally gonna spray and then dry. Seems to be much left in this one, but we will there we go. Now I'm just going to add a slight pop of this bright pink. And dry that. And there we go. That was as far as my planning went, so I think I might use a stencil next. Yeah, so I need to go away, think about it, maybe grab some stencils out, and I'll join with you in a minute. Yep, so I've got my much loved stencil and some neon pink. Cut a little bit off there. And the neon colours are not opaque, so we will see some of the background coming through, but I think for this journal that will work quite nicely. Love it. Do I want a little bit more? Perhaps a touch more up here also. I'm thinking a tiny bit, let me just move my glass of juice there, tiny bit up in this corner, just for a tiny bit of balance. Gonna have to move this palette. Like this. Gonna try and leave some white space. There we go. And I'm feeling a butterfly, so let me just grab that. I'll be right back. Okay, so I did just give that excuse me, a quick blast with the heat gun so that I don't smudge the flowers. I just need a little bit of this neon purple. Gonna snip that down again. So we've got a nice clean bit. Here we go, and then I think I'm gonna find a nice coat, and I think this page is done. Don't want to be over fussy with these. This is gonna be a lesson in simplicity for me, this journal. I have so many ideas that I've jotted down. I just hope that I don't lose momentum with it and I get bored. I have so many ideas, I may have to make another journal, but like I say, we'll see how far we get with it. There we go. Does it need? Let me just think. I think I may need to bring some more purple in with maybe just some different flowers. Some smaller flowers if I've got any. Let's have a look. Oops. That one, could maybe use that. I think that's going to be the one. Just found a stencil that I've bent quite badly. And flatten that out. Okay. So let's just have one or two. These. There we go. Now I'm just going to go and find a quote and we'll put that on and that'll be us done. Okay, so the word serenity just kind of popped into my head while I was thinking, so I took out these rub-ons and I'm getting near the end of them, so I don't have a T left. I'm going to have to use the number one and cut the little bit off the top. And if this doesn't show up as much as I want it to, I can always go over it with a paint pen. Straight if I can. Doesn't have the backing on it, I remember, if enough. Scratch that off. There we go. That looks like a T. There we go. And then I think just to finish it off, I'm going to grab my white Posca. If I can find it in this slot, I'm going to get the thin one. It's black. Well, I think I have a fine one in white. Just to bring that white in, I'm going to do a squiggly border we go. Let's have a double squiggle. That's that. I may apply a little bit of matte medium just over there, just to keep those letters down, because they do look like they are. A couple of them have got bits just poking up, so if I just seal them, and they won't move. So there we go. Hope you enjoyed the first page of my see-through journal. I really enjoyed it. Really simple, quick, and quite effective, I think. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye.